Hi, welcome back to my channel. Happy Friday. I have my front door open. My neighbor may start working on his house, so I will try and film this quickly. Bruce is doing okay. He has an appointment on Monday with his oncologist, and he's had good and bad days. Thank you for your well wishes for him. We really do appreciate it. In front of you, I have my cousin and my A5 HON. Let's flip through the weekly section of the HON. This is my functional planner that I have with me every single day. I don't know if you can see the patina, how it's not turning. So this is like the original color here. And then you can sort of see the slight coloring. And there's my neighbor. Hopefully it's not too loud. So this is what I've done this past week. And Bruce is playing with his toy. Haven't heard that in a really long time. Hopefully it won't be too loud for you. But for me, it's heaven on earth. So really functional. So this morning when I was drinking my coffee, I list down all the tasks that I need to get done today. And then Cookie Monster Co. washi tape, mail on this side. This is, again, a washi tape stamp that my nephew brought home for me as a souvenir from his Japan trip. This is for last week. And then the week before with the Minions. I wish I bought more of this. I think I found this at the 99-cent store or the Dollar Tree. I want to say last year or the year before. But yeah, these are so cute. So this is really functional. And now I'm going to show you what's in my cousin. And this is for this week. So you can see where it was really functional in here. This is prettier with more washi tape. Down here is where I'm still keeping track of my gardening plant related things. I write down here. Packages are over here. And I've been really happy with this, I guess, layout of what I've been doing. And then later today, I need to write down my task that I wrote in here this morning into here using stickers. This is for last week. This is a pencil board that I made. Instead of buying a pencil board like this one from Hobonichi, my husband likes to eat cereal in the morning. And so I just thought I'd cut it out for now to use it. And then back here is a popcorn box that my niece and nephew brought home from their Japan trip. And because it's a funny shape, I just went ahead and cut it down and then taped it to the back of this guy. So generally I write on this one, but this is kind of nice to look at from time to time. So kind of cheap looking, but sentimental to me. So that's all that matters. Now this is for last week, I think. Yes, so this is last week. I went with Gudetama. Again, you can see the gardening thing that I did here. This was the week before, Cookie Monster Co. The week before that. So this has been working really well for me. And let me just show you. I don't know if I've been keeping up with this part. Let's see. Okay, and then here's May. So today's Friday. So Bruce has his appointment on Monday. And then I have a doctor's appointment on Tuesday. So now let's go through the flip for the month of May. So this was the end of April. This is when we went to visit our vet for Bruce. This is the blank monthly page. I still haven't decided what I wanted to put on here, so I'm just going to leave this blank, and when I finally decide on something, I will come back and decorate it. For the month of April, this is what I did. I really like this picture. And for March, let me just show you that one really quick, because that one I did this one. So my mood for March was this, because we were still trying to figure out what was going on with Bruce, and was starting to get really stressful because our vet wasn't going negative, but he just didn't have anything really positive to say, because now he was starting to lean towards cancer, which was not on our radar for the past couple of months before we finally got the cancer diagnosis for Bruce. But this is what I did for February. And I did a thinking about, and so in this case, it was my mom, Bruce, the garden, career for my writing. And then let me sleep, because I wasn't getting enough sleep, being worried about Bruce and my mom. So I'm going to leave that blank until I can figure out what I want to do. So this is the first. This was, I think, a picture that I found in our AAA magazine, I think. It's either AAA or Costco. Those are the only two magazines, if you want to call it that, that we receive. And so I go through it, cut out things that I like. Like, here's some more images. So there's Bruce. Because of the medication that he's on for his cancer, he doesn't spend that much time anymore sleeping on the couch. He's been preferring to be on the floor or on this little rug thing that we have. The vet said that the medication that he's on keeps him on the hotter side, and so laying on the floor, I think, helps cool him down. On the third, I decided to spend time with Bruce because he spent so much time on the floor like this. I decided to set up my writing on the floor to be beside him. So I don't know if you can see, so that's the couch. And you can see Bruce on the left-hand side. So it's a two-seater recliner. So my husband generally sits on this side. This is generally my side. But because Bruce likes being up on the couch, he's basically taken over my spot. And so in the mornings and during the day, I would sit on this side and write. I would have my laptop set up on a TV tray, and then I would write. But lately, since we started his treatment, he's been preferring to sit behind me. And then he ended up kicking me off the couch. And so then I pulled out my computer chair and sort of have it set up over here. But anyways, on this day, I decided to set it up like that. He decided he didn't want to share the floor with me and decided to get back up on the couch. More washi tape from Cookie Monster Co. And then these are pictures of my sister and her husband. They are now first-time grandparents. So, obviously, I covered them up. A nice quote that I found online. Stickers are from Happy Planner. So, here are the different places that Bruce likes to lay down. And this was when he was sort of going through what I would call his bad days. He wasn't really feeling like himself. So I wrote a little bit about that. But on this day, Tuesday and Wednesday, he was starting to feel a little bit better. So here you can see my laptop. There's my computer chair that you can see right there. And then here he was kind of looking at me wanting to eat lunch. And then on Wednesday, he was starting to play with his toys. And he hasn't done that in over a month. It's been quite a while. So I was really happy when he decided to dig through his box of toys. And so I took a couple of pictures. And I think I filmed it. So if I do have that clip, I will insert that here. So really happy with his playfulness. He's kind of feeling like himself again. And then on Thursday, here we are. I was on my computer chair. He was on the couch. And so we were kind of looking out the window because I can't remember what was going on yesterday. But we were both looking out and decided to snap his photo. And then this is his hiding spot. He goes behind the chair to hide. And then right here is a word. It's called hellacious. Never heard of that word before, but I was watching somebody who kept saying it, found it really interesting, decided to look it up. It's a word, wrote down the definition. And then here's Friday, which is today. And that is a quick look of my cousin and my A5 hun. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you like to see after the pin videos generally of my Hobonichis, and I gotta let Bruce out now. Have a good weekend. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.